Hello everyone, my name is Shailesh Dwivedi. I'm responsible for product management and cloud engineering for Oracle's globally distributed autonomous database. Oracle's globally distributed autonomous database transparently distributes data across the globe for scale, survivability, and data sovereignty. What is a distributed database? It's a database that stores data across multiple physical locations instead of one location. Each location stores a subset of data. The physical distribution of data is hidden from the applications and it transparently gets routed to the right location. The Oracle database became a distributed database in 2017 when native database sharding was released. Today, it powers many critical distributed applications around the world. There are two main use cases for distributed databases. Ultimate scalability and survivability, where data is distributed and replicated across databases for hyperscale and fault tolerance. The second use case is transparent data sovereignty, where each country's data is stored in country to help implement regulatory requirements. An Oracle globally distributed database is a single logical database. Data is physically distributed across multiple databases, which are called shards. Data in each shard is replicated for survivability. All shards can process application requests. This enables an active-active architecture. Data can be redistributed across shards, data centers, and regions while the database is up and running. The distribution of data is hidden from the applications. Application requests that only need data from a single shard are transparently sent directly to that shard. Requests that need data from multiple shards are automatically split into multiple requests that are sent to the appropriate shards and committed atomically. Queries can be parallelized both within and across shards to implement a massively parallel analytics. This is the next generation of big data done right. Distributed database distribute data across multiple physical databases. This allows data to be placed in multiple geographic locations. It avoids single database scalability and survivability limits since databases are independent of each other. Requests that need data from multiple shards are automatically routed through a query coordinator. Let's take a look at two customer examples. Data sovereignty is becoming mandatory in many countries like India for payment data. The Reserve Bank of India data localization regulations state that payment data must reside in India if both the payer and the payee are Indian entities. This is a showstopper for global financial services companies that store data from all countries in a single database. The key observations here are that the data must be physically stored in India, but it can be accessed from anywhere. One of the largest US banks had to re-architect their payment database to satisfy this regulation. Initially, all worldwide payment data was stored in US on Exadata systems. The application and the database tier were replicated across region inside US for disaster recovery. Oracle's globally distributed database enabled the bank to easily comply with India's regulations. New shards were created in India to hold India data. The new database architecture required minimal application changes. The highly complex application tier architecture did not need to be redundantly deployed in India. One thing is guaranteed. Data regulation will only increase. In fact, a tidal wave of data regulations is coming as more countries roll out their own regulation and more industries become regulated. Oracle's globally distributed database implements features that can help you surf this tidal wave instead of being drowned by it. Let's take a look at another customer example. BlueKai is a leading data platform for digital marketing campaigns. The data is accessed in real time by hundreds of millions of consumers as they surf the internet. BlueKai is a hyperscale workload on a multi-petabyte database that requires near instant response time. It processes 1 million transactions per second and invokes 30 billion APIs per day with a response time of 1.6 milliseconds. BlueKai now runs on Oracle's globally distributed database. It runs on 104 commodity servers, which cumulatively have 5,408 CPU cores and 77.4 terabytes of memory. It was migrated from a combination of NoSQL products like Aerospike, Cassandra, CillaDB. The simplicity of new architecture plus the power of SQL enables BlueKai to innovate many times faster than before. The total data volume is 2.5 petabytes and is distributed across multiple data centers. Each of the shards in a data center has a replica in a different data center, hence enabling BlueKai to survive an outage of an entire data center. Oracle's globally distributed database is architecturally ahead of others. Oracle RAC was architected from day one to deliver full SQL in a scale-out cluster. Oracle has extended this mature parallel clustered SQL engine to support distributed scale-out architecture. Other distributed databases run on top of NoSQL engines. Some are slowly adding SQL on top, which would require decades of work. NoSQL engines allowed them to get to market quickly, but now they suffer from poor performance since NoSQL engines are not designed for SQL workloads. This is especially bad for reporting and analytics kind of queries. Oracle has more data distribution methods than any other distributed database. The data across multiple tables is partitioned and is, for a given sharding key, is co-located on one of the shards. For example, we have three tables: customer, order, and line items. And the data for Mary across all three tables, whose customer ID is 123, is co-located on shard number two. Likewise, John's data, which is in green, across all tables, is co-located on shard number three. And Peter's data, which is in blue, is co-located on shard number one. This allows us to execute joins in a very optimal manner. All the joins are satisfied locally on a given shard. Additionally, all the constraints are also satisfied on a given shard. If we have certain tables, which are more like dimension table or reference tables, in this case, like a product catalog, the data for those such tables is automatically replicated across all shards. Such tables are called duplicate tables. Oracle supports value-based data distribution. This distributes data by a value, for example, a country code or a product ID, or distribute data by a range of values, for example, ranges of phone numbers. Oracle supports system-managed data distribution. It uses a consistent hash algorithm to evenly distribute data across shards for scalability and parallelism. For example, to distribute data by customer ID, device ID, or action ID. Consistent hash enables online addition of shards with minimal data movement. Oracle also supports composite data distribution. This is two levels of sharding with two different sharding keys and two different sharding methods. Data is first distributed by value, for example, a country code, or a range, for example, a phone number. Then, data is distributed evenly across data centers, for example, using a customer ID as a second sharding key, using consistent hashing as a second sharding method. Oracle also supports user-defined data distribution. This is useful when data requires special handling, such as skewed data. For example, we can store Taylor Swift's and Beatles' data in their own shard and combine smaller artists' data together in a separate shard. Oracle supports duplicate data distribution. This is useful for small tables that are read-only, can be duplicated across all shards. This is used to avoid cross-shard queries and cross-shard referential integrity checks. Oracle supports partition data distribution within each shard. For example, the data in any shard can further be partitioned by data values such as date range, and then further partitioned by another data value or hash. This enables faster queries and join within a shard. Shards can also be added without incurring any downtime, and the data automatically gets redistributed across shard. This is to enable scale out or scale in for seasonality. Data across shards is automatically rebalanced with minimum data movement. This is an online operation and does not incur any downtime. Oracle has more replication methods than any other distributed database. Oracle replication is designed for real-world networks. Real-world distributed networks are flaky. They incur long latencies, intermittent slowdowns, and unpredictable stalls that can wreak havoc on the application response time and availability. Oracle Distributed Database replication can be configured to satisfy the needs of each application. For example, can be configured in a synchronous replication manner, asynchronous replication manner, adaptive synchronous replication, or a combination of local synchronous and remote asynchronous replication. Oracle replication can meet any scaling or survivability needs. It supports redo level replication using Active Data Guard that provides fastest performance, most comprehensive SQL functionality, readable replicas, and provides simplest operation. It also supports SQL level replication using Golden Gate that provides fastest failover, fully writable replicas, including conflict avoidance and resolution. Oracle has more shard deployment architectures than any other distributed database. Oracle can be deployed on independent servers. This is a simple, low-cost deployment option that is very popular. Shards can run on standalone commodity servers. Oracle can deploy shards on fault-tolerant, scalable clusters as well. Oracle can uniquely scale performance within a shard or a region using an ultra-fast Exadata scale-out cluster. This enables data to be accessed within a region without slow cross-shard access and coordination. Failure or maintenance of servers or databases in a cluster does not require disruptive application failover to a replica. Oracle can deploy shards across on-premises, in cloud, and multiple clouds. You can choose the deployment option independently for each shard or country. This can be optimized for scaling needs and cloud availability of each region. Oracle can deploy shards within a fault-tolerant cluster. This is useful for customers who want the highest transparency and simplicity and don't need the distributed data or sovereignty or ultimate scale-out. Sharding is used to route SQL to a specific node of a cluster for increased access locality and hotspot avoidance. Cross-shard SQL within a cluster is super fast, unlike the distributed shards. Oracle's globally distributed database is designed for modern applications. Modern applications use multiple data technologies. For example, they use new types of data like relational, JSON, spatial, graph, new types of analytics like SQL, machine learning, new workload types like AI, vectors, Internet of Things, blockchain. One approach is to deploying rich modern apps is to use a specialized database for each application needs. The specialized database approach makes data sovereignty nearly impossible. Each database has a different data sovereignty architecture. It has different APIs, different capabilities, and a unique set of limitations. Application developers and IT strives to make every database comply with data sovereignty regulation and makes all data flow between database compliant. Oracle's converged database architecture simplifies distributed databases. It provides a complete and a simple support for all modern data types, workloads, and development styles in one database, with complete and simple consistency, scalability, and availability. It provides unified data sovereignty for all data types and workloads. Oracle recently released Oracle Globally Distributed Autonomous Database. It adds autonomous management to eliminate the operational complexity of a distributed database and reduces cost. It's a combination of globally distributed database and Oracle Autonomous Database, which enables a globally distributed autonomous database, which is the simplest, most functional, most mission-critical cloud-native distributed database service. Now let's take a look at the demo of Oracle Globally Distributed Autonomous Database. I'm logged into Oracle Cloud Infrastructure Console, from where we'll quickly go through a flow of creating a globally distributed autonomous database. We provide a few options which we can leave to default if we don't want to change. Subsequently, we can configure how we want to distribute the data, whether we want to use automated or user-defined data distribution. And we can provide the number of shards we need in each of the locations. Optionally, we can use a map to pick the locations where we want to deploy shards. For example, I want to deploy some shards in Phoenix, some in London, some in Mumbai, some in Tokyo. Then we can configure each of these shard locations and specify how many shards we want in each location. For example, 3 shards in Phoenix, and I leave 1 in other regions. We can then specify the shape and the size for each of the shard and whether we need a replica or not. Here, I'm going to select that my shard 1 in Phoenix, I want to deploy in availability domain 1. We start with 2 eCPUs. We want to enable auto scaling. This allows us to vertically scale each of the shard as the workload increases and conversely scale down if the workload decreases. We want to configure replication for this shard in a different region. I want to keep my US data within US and I'll pick the US East, which is Ashburn, as my replica location. And I want to put my replica in availability domain 3. Likewise, I can configure rest of the shapes and sizes and replication for rest of the shards. And with a few click of a button, I will be able to create a globally distributed autonomous database. I'm going to cancel out of this workflow and go back and look at a globally distributed autonomous database, which has already been provisioned. For example, this database spans multiple locations, including Hyderabad in India, Mumbai, Phoenix, Ashburn, etc. It's a single logical database and application connects to it using a single logical endpoint. Additionally, if you want to use over-the-wire encryption, we can download the wallet and configure TLS. We can also visualize all the shards across the globe as a single logical database, and we can look at some of the performance metrics. Additionally, we have the ability to add a shard later, start the entire globally distributed database, stop it or terminate it, so on and so forth. Let's go back and look at some other concepts. Oracle brings natural language query to globally distributed database using autonomous database select AI that can translate natural language questions into SQL using an AI large learning model. The SQL query is automatically routed to the appropriate country or shard by the globally distributed database. For example, if I want to ask a question, how many total streams for each Tom Cruise movies were viewed in India this month? In this case, the large learning model generates the SQL, which already has country code as India, and hence Oracle's globally distributed database routes this query only to the shard in India. There are some exciting features coming soon in Oracle Database 23 AI. One of them is Raft-based replication for extreme survivability. This is a new replication method that uses popular Raft quorum-based replication protocol. This provides automatic failover to a replica in under 3 seconds. It implements an active-active symmetric configuration. Each shard accepts writes and reads for a subset of data. It also delivers a zero data loss using a high-performance synchronous replication across shards. AI vector search and retrieval augmented generations are also available with Oracle's globally distributed database 23AI. Oracle distributed database will add hyperscale and data sovereignty to Oracle Database's 23AI vector search. Customers will be able to combine similarity search using AI vectors with search on business data about customers' products in a single distributed query. Here are the key takeaways. Oracle's globally distributed database is the most fully featured distributed database. It provides more data distribution, replication, and deployment methods than any other database. Converged database architecture makes data sovereignty easy for modern applications that use multiple data types and workloads. The new 23AI Raft-based replication provides fast quorum-based failover. It supports leading-edge AI such as vector search, and its autonomous capabilities remove complexity and reduce cost. Provides all the benefits of a distributed database without the compromises. So why settle for less?